other thoughts. So the mind is nothing but a bundle of thoughts, and I thought is the primary thought which gives rise to other thoughts. Once you start inquiring what is this I, that I thought disappears, because you can't find a very specific I thought. It's all contextual. For example, I am interacting with him, there's an I thought. So then that I thought disappears and I interact with you. Okay, the I thought appears and disappears like a wave. There's no solid I. What is there is a background consciousness which is not changing, which is eternal. Understand? It's like a wave comes and goes back. Wave comes and goes. Every interaction, one wave comes and goes. So these waves appear and disappear in consciousness. The consciousness is the background. And this wave which comes, we call it as I thought. Right? It is context dependent, it's a perception dependent. But the real I is not a thought, it's a background, complete consciousness, the consciousness. Shiva Swarup, Shiva. So if you really search for I thought, there's no I thought. Right? Not permanent I thought. It's appearing and disappearing. Then what is giving us feeling of permanence? Two things. One is the body and other is the memory. The I thought is a product of memory. It gives you history. So if you, the moment you think of something, I thought is appearing, but it comes with a history. I am so and so. So if you really inquire into the nature of memory, what is there in the memory, you find that the I thought is coming out of memory is also false. You have to understand the nature of memory. So then we consider body as I. Even that is false, because body is constantly changing. So in reality what's happening is the I thought which is constantly changing, we are giving a solidity and say this is I. And that I is searching for enlightenment, which is actually constantly changing. So what is enlightenment is that I has to realize that it's not that, it's not real. It's false. And what is real is consciousness. So there is a consciousness and there are some bodies. Okay. I identify with the body or I identify with memory and think that I am a solid entity, which is not true. And this is the cause of our problem, because the solid entity we have to protect. All our life struggle is to protect that solid entity called I. But on inquiry, you find that there is no such solid entity called I. The solid entity itself was illusionary, not real. So then its solid entity starts dissolving. So the I dissolves, okay? And when I dissolves, what remains is consciousness. The consciousness is not individual, it's universal. Consciousness in your body, consciousness in her body, consciousness everywhere, it's all same. So it's universal. So then there's no individual. All the while, the universe was appearing as individuals and going. Like ocean was appearing waves and disappearing. But wave started thinking that I'm separate. That's the problem. So now everything is consciousness. And when everything is consciousness, you have become Brahman. You are Brahman. You are the Supreme Reality. You are Shiva Swarupa. And for that, you have to let go what you are not. Let go what you are not. By understanding, why I am not the body, why I am not the mind, why I am not intellect, why I am not memory, that understanding has to be clear. And that dissolves that I. And then what remains is pure consciousness. That's called Nirvana, that's called Mukti, that's called Shiva Swarupa. So you have to let go. Nanu. Nanembudu.
Nanembudu.
Nanalla.
Nanalla.
Ideha.
Ideha.
Manabuddhi.
Manabuddhi.
Nanalla.
Nanalla.
Sachidanandatma.
Sachidanandatma.
Shivananu Nani.
Shivananu Nani.
Shivoham.
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 ಶಿವೋಹಂ.
ಈ ನಾನು ಕಳ್ಚೋಗ್ಬೇಕು, ನಾನು ಕರ್ಗೋಗ್ಬೇಕು. ನಿಜವಾಗ್ಲು ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲ, ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲ, ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್. ಆ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡೆಂಟ್ ಐ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ದಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ ಪರ್ಮನೆಂಟ್ ಐ. ರಿಯಲಿ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಐ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್, ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಥಾಟ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಐ ಆಮ್. When you start searching for I disappears. That's called Mukti. So now, when the I disappears, other thoughts also disappear. So, but that person, when he starts still he has a body. When he interacts, he will use an eye, knowing very well that this is a transaction like for a specific function. It is not a permanent eye. So like that he lives. That's called Jivan Mukta. Shall we close for the day?